We have breaking news coming in from Virginia, where the state's lieutenant governor just denied a second woman's claim of sexual assault. Let's go to CNN's Ryan Nobles, working the story for us. He's joining us live from Richmond. So what's the latest, Ryan? What are you learning?
Yeah, that's right, Wolf. This second woman, Meredith Watson, put out a statement through her attorney about a half an hour ago where she accuses the lieutenant governor, Justin Fairfax, of rape when they were both college students at Duke University in 2000. This is what Watson said through her attorney. She said, quote, Mr. Fairfax's attack was premeditated and aggressive. The two were friends but never dated or had any romantic relationship. Ms. Watson shared her account of the rape with friends in a series of emails and Facebook messages that are now in our possession. Additionally, we have statements from former classmates corroborating that Ms. Watson immediately told friends that Mr. Fairfax had raped her. Of course, Wolf, this second accusation comes just days after Dr. Vanessa Tyson, another woman, claimed that she had been sexually assaulted by the lieutenant governor back in 2004 during the Democratic National Convention. Now, at that time, the lieutenant governor had forcefully denied those accusations, and he's forcefully denying these accusations tonight as well. This is what he says in a statement. He says, quote, I deny this latest unsubstantiated allegation. It is demonstrably false. I have never forced myself on anyone ever. I demand a full investigation into these unsubstantiated and false allegations. Such an investigation will confirm my account because I am telling the truth. I will clear my good name, and I have nothing to hide. I have passed two full field background checks by the FBI and run for office in two highly contested elections with nothing like this being raised before. It is obvious that a vicious and coordinated smear campaign is being orchestrated against me. And Wolf, this is perhaps the most important thing he says in this statement, I will not resign. Now, despite the fact that the lieutenant governor seems insistent that he will not leave office, despite this flood of controversy that is surrounding him right now, the calls for his resignation have already begun, and they've come from the highest levels. The former governor of Virginia, someone still very influential here in the Commonwealth, Terry McAuliffe, tweeting just a few minutes ago, quote, the allegations against Justin Fairfax are serious and credible. It is clear to me that he can no longer effectively serve the people of Virginia as lieutenant governor. I call for his immediate resignation. And of course, Wolf, this would be a very damaging scandal under any circumstances. But when you take it in the context of the fact that the governor is currently embattled after he appeared there was a racist photo that appeared in his medical school yearbook, and the attorney general is also facing a scandal when he admitted just a few days ago that he appeared in blackface while in college. And this is a state of turmoil for the Commonwealth of Virginia. There have already been calls across the board for the governor to step down. He has said that he is not going anywhere. Those calls were renewed in many respects yesterday. Now we have the lieutenant governor facing an increasingly difficult controversy. Well, frankly, there is no clue specifically how this will resolve itself. And the people of Virginia remain in a state of turmoil here as these controversies continue to mount.
Yeah, the turmoil clearly continues. Ryan Nobles for us in Richmond. Thanks very much.